Hi everyone, Mr. Morgan Lewis here at the school. In this video, we're going to delve a bit more into something called preemptive striking. Now, if you don't know what preemptive striking is, it's basically your ability to strike right before something happens from the other side. So, for instance, if this pad, as a sort of pretend, was, you know, someone very, very close in my face and was looking like they were getting ready to throw a punch, it's kind of like me sending the strike in before theirs is fully set up. So I kind of know it's going to happen. Obviously, it's a bit like when someone pushes you with both hands and then gives you this action, you kind of know they're gonna push again or they're gonna try and grab you. So your preemptive strike or preemptive movement will be to go one step ahead. So preemptive strikes can be used in different ways. We're gonna talk about three different types. So the first one we're going to talk about is the elbow strike. And although it is a very, very powerful and dangerous strike, if it's unseen, it can change a whole situation for you very, very easily. Obviously, the purpose of a preemptive strike is to strike a target or an opponent coming towards you quickly and effortlessly so that they'll either, you know, it can cause unconsciousness or it will just give them a stun enough for you to then get away if need be. And when it comes to self-defense, we will always say, run away if you can, but if you can't avoid the situation, then of course you need to use your skills. So if we're talking about an elbow, when it comes to a situation when we're faced with an aggressor, the last thing we want is our hands down here or behind our back or like this. Some people do this, but the trouble with that is you're talking milliseconds to put your guard up or cover yourself. And for all you know, you could be faced up against someone that is maybe an amateur boxer or has actually been in the ring a few times or is just a genuine thug that just loathes on what they do. Regardless of what kind of person it is, you should have your hands close. So I'd always recommend bringing them up in sort of in front of you in a open hand, non-threatening gesture so that it gives you a chance to sort of say, whoa, what's your problem, mate? And that sort of thing. Or, you know, can we talk about this? Obviously, at times it goes beyond that straight away, but at least you've tried. But the thing about your hands being here is my target is now right here, okay? So let's say there's the head, there's the torso, there's the shoulders, presuming they're the same sort of height as me. Then from here, it's not much effort for me to just put my strike in. And this is where the elbow comes in because it doesn't take long to travel. And it's a very, very powerful, devastating shot. Obviously, it's not ideally what we want to do in a self-defense situation, but if you feel like you have no choice, you have no choice. So from here, my hands would be in this position here. So I'd probably be looking to clasp a shoulder or the side of the head or something, or whichever. I don't necessarily want to look like the aggressor at this point, which is why I'm standing here like this, not like this. If I do this, that tells the other person we want to scrap, okay? We don't want to do that. We want to have our hands open so that we seem like the non-threatening person. And simply, we want to take control of the situation. When it comes to self-defense, the other person has to be the one that attacks first so that you are not held liable for what happens. The moment that they make a movement towards you, you're in the clear, okay? But of course, you still need to be reasonable of what you do. I'm not saying an elbow is the most reasonable approach, but however, when it comes to self-defense, you do what you have the right to do what you need to do, but you need to be responsible for it. But of course, if you're in a situation where you feel you're threatened or your life is threatened, then you need to do it. So your hands are here. Target's really, really close to you, okay? From here, it's just a simple case of thumb or finger straight to the chest and then flipping the elbow in place. Now, although it doesn't seem like a very, very powerful shot without the technique at the moment, it's the surprise. This is the idea of the preemptive strike. It's a surprising attack. If I stood back and then launch my arm up like this, they're gonna see it coming more likely, and then the body will prepare for it by covering, tensing up, whichever. Whereas if I'm this close to an opponent and just pop that in there, it's like, whoa, that's a real surprise. And very often the surprises are the ones that do the most damage or cause the most disruption. Okay, so that's that one. Now, another one that we tend to favor is just a simple palm strike. And the reason we choose the palm strike as opposed to fist is because you have potential to do a lot of damage to your knuckles and wrists. You might train for years to hold a fist correctly and how to punch correctly, but in the heat of the moment, if you don't necessarily use your training, you could injure yourself. And then of course, if you punch wrong hurt your wrist or something, it's then going to make the situation harder for you. So we would recommend usually just using your palm heels, because that is a very, very strong area. The other thing is, obviously looking at a pad you can't see, but on a human face as such, there are lots of nerves dotted all the way around the temple and the head that we can target with a palm strike. And what we do is we get a cluster of points. But basically what you need to know at this point is that the palm strike is nowhere near likely as to fail as a fist. Okay, so again, your hands are in this position. So from there, it's again, it doesn't take long to reach the target. Maybe you have to slip a little and then pump it in. That's fine. But again, your hands are here. So sort of to say, look, I don't, any problem, mate. You know, can we talk about this? You know, that sort of situation. And then if you feel like something's going to happen, then you want to make sure you pull one hand back in close and the other one goes straight out. And to be honest, targeting the forehead or anywhere around the jaw is a good idea, or the bridge of the nose, something like that. Just to give you time, just to give you a change in the situation. Like I said, so you can either run away or you can take control of it. Okay, so your preemptive strike will be here and then boom, straight in. And again, it's a surprise, it's the shock of it. This isn't the most powerful strike in the world, but it's one of the quickest, okay? Now, of course, you have the elbow, you have that, and then also you have the large looping side like slap or hook. Most times we get something called a sucker punch, which is very common amongst people that they don't want someone to necessarily know that they're about to get hit. So they approach from a different angle, or, you know, the hands are down here first of all, and then suddenly you get this going. And the only reason that usually works is because the other person doesn't see it coming. The body doesn't have time to prepare for that kind of strike. It is a preemptive strike, but it's slightly different. It's more of an unexpected assault. Whereas what we'd be using that for is the essence that perhaps they start to clench their fists. Maybe they're starting to put their hands in this position here. Maybe they're doing this. It's gesturing gives it away. Okay, you can always tell by the body language of someone how things are going to go. If someone wanted to sucker punch you or get you without you realizing, then they would have done it a long time ago. They wouldn't have got in front of your face to do it. Of course, there isn't really much defense against surprise attacks like that, other than just be aware of your surroundings and, you know, be prepared to cover if need be. But you know that the other person is obviously out for you. They obviously have a problem. So how can we use that strike ourselves? Well, again, it depends on the angle. You might be grabbed here suddenly and, you know, you don't have a lot of access to the body or to the straight to the head. So let's imagine that this thing had arms here on the lapels. So again, your hands would be here like, whoa, whoa, whoa. And then, you know, just out of nowhere, round the side, you know, across the side of the ear or side of the neck, again, along the jawline. Because we're still using an open palm, we're going to get a cluster of points there. Okay, so it's one of those strikes that doesn't take long to get to. It doesn't take long for it to get to the target. Now, if you use your training and use your pivoting, just like you do with a hook punch, it's exactly the same. Just, yeah. And again, a surprise attack like that is more likely to do some more damage than a regular, you know, prepare for it and go in for it. Okay, so to sum it all up, hands like this, okay? Keep your chin down as well to protect you. And don't put them in a necessarily guard position unless you're at distance. If you're at distance, then put them up. But if you're really close, you don't have a lot of time to move back, or you don't think you can move back, just have them close. And then either respond with an elbow, particularly if they're about to hit you, okay? You've also got the straight push attack if they start to get much more aggressive and up towards you. All right, to try and create an opening. Or of course, if they're grabbing you like so, then just quickly round the side. But until something like that happens, you can't really judge it until the situation happens. Hopefully it doesn't for any of you. You know, no one likes to get involved in a self-defense situation, but it never hurts to be ready. Okay, so that was just a little bit on preemptive strikes. So the main thing to remember about them is that they're surprise attacks, but they're only to be used when you sense something's about to happen. It's not an excuse for you to send a strike straight in during a verbal conflict, because then that makes you look like the aggressor. You need to watch the body language, the way the body responds, how they respond, and, you know, you need to make your judgment there and then. All right. So if they throw a shot towards you and you manage to guard it and then do your preemptive strike back, that's fine. But again, you need to use it at the right time. Hopefully that's given you something to think about there. As always, like and share the video and leave us a comment. And if anyone has any doubts about a certain situation or anyone has a scenario that they can think of that they might need some advice on, then of course we can put that forward as best we can for you. But as always, if you're going to practice these, we usually practice them in class, but just be aware of it. Don't necessarily go practicing it outside of the school. It's mainly for inside, but it's just something for you to think about. If you know the next time you're out and about, something happens, you know you've got an idea. Okay, so as always, happy training. Look after yourselves, and hope you enjoyed the video.